So welcome back. I'm gonna do the street race that I promised in the previous episode. And yeah, I'm sure it's just taken us through these disciplines, the first race or two, until we get to do either our own stuff or the bigger kind of things. So this is the way it goes. Nothing's always given to you straight away. Have I got a Durango?
Let's do this.
Not the kind of car I'd use to drag race or street race at all.
You made it. I'm Jay, by the way. Alex wouldn't shut up about you, you know. If you drive half as well as he says you can, these guys will love you. Oh, before we start, you've got to know this isn't strictly sanctioned by the festival. So don't mention this to Kira, all right? I gotta go. Work to do. See you around, though, yeah? These might not be official, but you keep coming to these meets, I'll make sure everyone at Horizon knows your name. Looking forward to seeing what you can do out there. Have fun now, yeah?
I will. Lotus 3v8 next to me. TVR Sagaris in front. Some Toyota off-roader and a BMW X6, is that? Traffic got in the way there. Hit that wall by accident and lost a lot of ground. Get too curious about whether or not cars are new or not to the series. Somebody took out traffic. Don't park on the double yellow lines, you'll get a parking fine. Home stretch coming up.
Races have all these unspoken rules about respect and honor and who can and can't join, but all you need to know is drive like that and you're welcome anytime.
Thank you. Even more money. I did check to see whether or not the auto show was unlocked yet, and it's not, so getting all this money, I'm not even able to spend it yet.
Starting soon if you fancy it. See you there. Oh, and me and Jay have just finished setting up a new danger sign. You should check it out if you fancy some thrills along the way.
Yeah, we will. We'll do this and then we'll go to that next dirt race. sure this Lancia will be up to the job of getting some distance on that danger side. I just keep trying to spot cars. That was a Maserati, I think, that went by. There's a Renault 5 Turbo. Ford Escort. Subaru up front. Danger sign, here we come. Come on, more speed.
You have arrived at your destination.
Is that enough for 3 stars?
People boarded up to mark potential hazards. Then me and Alex went around and put whacking great flags on all of them. Voila, a danger sign is born. So long as you survive, they'll probably let us build more.
10 grand out of that and more influence. Do this race and we'll progress to the autumn part.
In 400 yards, turn right.
Seems to be that if you're in a certain type of car, that type of car will be more prevalent than any other. That's why you keep seeing rally cars and the like around. Indeed I have. Surprised it's given me these cars that I've been using so far for free. Never expected to have to buy them. Well, that's fine by me, it means I get to save money. Right, let's see if we can cut it here like we did last time. Those walls really do slow you down if you stay in them too long. It was entirely my fault. Sorry, fellow Lancia, I did not mean to do that. Came off that jump at the wrong angle. The way chickens should not be on a racetrack. Unless you're going to be trying to play chicken. So the difficulty is getting used to the handling physics and the driving style that you have to have in these games over the Forza Motorsport games and the like, because, you know, I'm playing that game for about a year with very little in the way of, you know, not playing it, so it's all about getting used to it. Once we've got past all this introductory stuff, I think I will bump up the driver's hard difficulty one more level. rest of the autumn season now.
Right. Good news is you've made the cut for the Horizon autumn season. Bad news, obviously, is that it doesn't start until autumn. You don't mind sticking around, do you?
Nope, not at all.
Hey, I owe you big time for helping me out earlier. Meet me here. I want to repay your favor.
Do we get a house? Seems I do. Let's get racing there. The Gables. I don't have to go left. I go over here instead. The whole point in this game is not to follow all the rules of the road. So we can make it up here. Screw your instructions, Anna. Shaved off a fair bit of distance there. Oops, sorry, Renault. Misjudged the different distance between us. Dangerous, dangerous. Yeah, not quite going 40 mile an hour there. What's this over here? It's a beauty shot, yeah. Beauty spot even. Ah, it's a horse. A well-known landmark in the UK.
Ah, the Offington White Horse. This thing's incredible. The first prehistoric display of horsepower. One.
And it doesn't move anywhere. Well, that was nice to find that. 1 of 12.
In 400 yards,
let's check out our house.
Turn left.
Broadway.
You have arrived at your destination.
You're not gonna believe this. The film producers bought this house to use as a set, but when filming wrapped, they just left it. I had a word, and you know what? They said you could have the house for free as a thank you for your work on the movie.
Yeah, that's quite a nice house in a nice area, and that would not be cheap. Guarantee it'd be well over half a million.
Excellent.
But free house is a free house.
Well, since this one's on the movie company, here's the keys. If nothing else, you can store your threads here. Your wardrobe is like a map of your career. So the more you get yourself out there, the more clothes you get in return. Speaking of which, I see you've already made a name for yourself before coming to Horizon UK. So I ordered in some exclusive threads as a thank you.
Thank you. Obviously these ones then. Forza 6, Forza 7, Forza Horizon 2, Forza Horizon 3. Forza 5. Jackets. Get a grey hoodie on. Get that, because it looks kind of retro in 80s. Which is my kind of thing. And some Converse. Traditionally British thing there. I don't want a cap on. New. gates all locked. Well, I want that, obviously. Oh no, that one. I like that one. That was I think he wore the white suit bit at the top in Goldfinger at the beginning.
You any good at dancing? You can bust a move to show off before a race, and bust an even bigger move for when you win. Trust me, it'll be great.
Right. That's the non-car essentials sorted. Right, this is the kind of stuff I get for my support. So rewards based on your loyalty tier. Forza Motorsport 7 shirt and super wheel spin. Shirt and super wheel spin. Shirts and, well, plenty of wheel spins. Clock Tower Horn and super wheel spin. Another shirt. Forza quick chat phrase plus super wheel spin. I get the Alfa Romeo Giulia Quadrifoglio. Good car. And then reward for playing Forza Horizon 3, the Ford F-150 Raptor truck, and reward for Forza Motorsport 7. 2018 Ford. Oh, the new Mustang GT. Very nice. Let's have a look at them. Oh, they're not there. For whatever reason. Ah, there we go. So that's the Alfa Romeo Quadrifoglio. Giulia Quadrifoglio. That's a new Mustang. What power has it got? No, oh, well, what do I do? No, there we go, 460 horsepower, £420 feet of torque. And finally, they brought the displacement back for Forza Horizon. It wasn't on Forza Motorsport 7, and it just baffled me that you had to go into Auto Vista or Forza Vista and find it out yourself by looking under the hood, or on Wikipedia if you couldn't do that. So, yeah, I'm glad that's quite frankly back. And we also get launch back as well, which is, again, another handy thing to have. Don't know why the launch and the displacement were missing from Forza Motorsport, but you would have thought a racing game would have those kind of things, but obviously not. I think we're getting the Alpha. I'll try out the Mustang in a review. This is a new one, a new car that we've not had before. And then obviously, No. How do I rise? How do I get up off the floor? What's that? Well, they're lights, obviously, but what was that? Ah, that's the, we never saw that, I think, on Forza Motorsport 7, so that's a pretty good addition. And then obviously you can open the boot. Just wondering why the hell I'm on the floor and not able to get up at all. Oh well, let's get out there. Bye, nice house. Oh, here we go, autumn. Frank Sinatra song Autumn Leaves in my head now.
Well, look who made it to the autumn season. You are this close to qualifying for the next round of the Dirt Racing Series. You should come back to Tarnhouse, it's completely different in autumn.
I still want to know if we can go in the fourth of... No, we can't, we can yet. Damn and blast.
Hey, Monkey. We've added some more stations to your radio. If you're into drum and bass, then tune into Hospital Records.
I'm really
and
not.
And if you're into something much calmer, Timeless FM is back with a healthy dose of classical. In 400 yards, turn left.
This is my sort of thing.
Turn left.
I'm in an Alpha. I have to have classical music while in an Alpha. It's a classical kind of car. And since I don't get monetize videos anymore. I don't have to care about copyright. So screw it. I'm pretty sure classical music is in the public domain anyway. I mean, who's going to own something that's 400 years old? So, yeah. Whee! Love this alpha. So glad Alfa Romeo got back into the sports saloon business, because they had several sports saloons back in the early 90s that were really, really good. Alfa Romeo 75, the Alfa Romeo 155Q4. So the fact that, I mean, yeah, they've had saloons later than that, but they were generally front wheel drive and very nice to look at, not very sporty. Board here to smash, wherever it may be, behind here.
Yep. So Kira told me about these. Smash a fast travel board and you'll get a discount on the Horizon fast travel service. Smash them all and the festival will cover your costs completely. Good to keep in mind for our many adventures.
But why fast travel in a game that has great cars and good handling? Sure, do it in the crew too, where, you know, it's quite annoying at times, but with this game, there's no need. Small enough map where driving anywhere is not arduous, let alone with a car that you like driving. Don't think I'm going to be able to race this on this bit, or maybe I am. Right then, a rear wheel drive saloon car on a dirt track.
Slippy out there because of all that rain we've been getting.
Yeah, we'll
apart that. Same course, totally different drive.
Well, it's pretty good that you can just pitch up in any car and just race it, even if it isn't the most suitable thing. Especially since we've only got rear wheel drive, and you've got the likes of the Panamera and that Merc E-Class, which has all wheel drive. And I've completely missed that checkpoint. Sliding everywhere. Hoping that the new cars that we added in DLC are a bit more reflective of the British kind of motoring scene and the kind of cars that we buy. Because, like I said in my brief roundup of the car list, without any obviously pictures of actually using this game, get, you know, Renaults, Citroëns, and Peugeots are hugely popular over here in Britain. And I'm not expecting the normal kind of versions, but if we can have the fast versions like Peugeot GTIs, isn't the 308, that's awful. And you know, fast Renaults, fast Citroëns. Give me the C4 or the C1 GT or whatever it is from Citroën. It's a pretty decent car, that. Even if you're not into classical music, you can enjoy this kind of classical music. It's more like pop culture kind of stuff. You've probably heard it in Top Gear or on an advert. We're going up against an Audi as well, they've got all wheel drive. Damn. Come on, find grip. That Infiniti has all wheel drive as well. Probably turn the music down a little bit though, it seems a bit loud. course, the Audi's better through water with that all-wheel drive system. How that Merc is keeping it on the straight and narrow when it has pretty much the same kind of power as me. Well, we were bound to not get a win in eventually. I chose to up the driver's tire difficulty right when I was on a dirt track with a rear wheel drive V6 powerful car. So. Bound to happen eventually, wasn't it? Any races that I don't win them with this, then I'll do my own time.
Thank you very much.
Just to make sure that we've got stuff.
It doesn't matter if you've already done this route. The fans will keep coming back for more. You'll get noticed, and
sweet
it'll help
super
you
wheel spin.
For the next round. It's a win-win.
Hey, monkey. Oh, there's an eight. Oh yeah, we already seen the AMD R1, but we got the new, a newish Nissan GTR, a horn, and a Galaxy Blazer. Not the most fashionable piece of outfits, but whatever. Yeah, that Aston Martin looked like something different that I would have liked as well, but it looked like a Jaguar C-Type originally.
Hey, monkey. Welcome to the Horizon Autumn season. My team are helping me find our most influential rookie to compete in the next showcase. Want it to be you? Convince me. Beck tells me you're in round two of the Road Racing Series. And Joel mentioned that someone named Mike Steele is after you about a stunt thing. Speaking of stunts, Jay's on the hunt for our next stunt hero. And Alex says he's ready to kick off round two of dirt racing. But he's really excited to get going on the cross-country series.
All
well,
right. God.
What are you waiting for?
You to be quiet. God. I don't know what to do so much. Let's just do another stunt. Let's see if this one's any harder. Just quickly turn
hey,
on the music though. Yay. Right, thank you. Audio. Turn it down to 5. Right, what's been added to what? Well, we've got one wheel spin, so we'll do that. Give me something good. Please have a lot of money or a nice car that I really, really like. Oh, that'll do. No, I thought it was going to give me the Bel Air then.
You'll look sharp in those.
I really
you
won't.
Head home to change
I hate
like, or just do it here at the festival site.
Right, I've got 9 super wheel spins to do, so that's fine by me. Hopefully we'll get some good cars out of this. Well, IHC, a Jaguar XES, and an XK120. Fan of the XES, fan of the XK120, nuts. I do like the 8C, but I don't like Forza Edition cars, really. So, right, let's go again. Let's just skip him. 200 grand, a new horn. Oh, and a Lamborghini Murcielago. One of my favourite cars on Forza Motorsport 7. It should be on here as well. Let's skip it. Jazz hands, Galaxy leggings, and a Ferrari 488 GTB. Ferrari's good, those Galaxy leggings will go with my Galaxy jacket, and jazz hands are, I guess, funny in some way. Another horn, and denim jacket, and silver leggings. Nothing good there then. Well, maybe the denim jacket's alright. Oh yes, an XKRS from 2012, gold waistcoat, meh. But 170 grand, I'll take that. 150 grand again, gold leather jacket and classic running man. We're racking up the money, that's for sure. Windows XP shutdown, strike, and a leopard trophy. Rubbish. Rubbish again. I don't need a skirt, really, I don't. Let alone a chainmail one. Oh well, at least I've finally got some more money, 150 grand. Right, I've got a couple of messages. Gifts, yay. Gifted clothing, and 350 grand. Very nice. It's probably Forza Hub money, that, to be honest. Right, we've got 1.2 million. Very nice. Ah, we can finally go to the festival. Right. Marketplace. Two car packs. Obviously the best of Bond, and then the Forza edition. Well, the Drift, whatever. What is in this? Nissan 240Z SX, BMW 325i. See, this is the problem with these kind of things. I'd rather have that BMW in its standard form. I really would, because we've never had a 1989 325i. And, yeah, don't think we've ever had the 97 Nissan 240SX either. So even though these are, you know, cool for the drifting community, etc., it's just, you know, I'd rather have the standard version of these two, to be honest. But, hey, come what may. Alright, gonna end, no, we'll do the stunt and then we'll end it there.
Just letting you know, the auto show is now open. Come on down and browse. Or I can send the catalogue to your house if you prefer. In 100 yards, turn left.
Which is kind of ripping off the Argos catalogue there. If you know what I'm on about, then you're as informative as me about British life. Let's go do this jump, well, stunt or whatever it is, and then we'll end it there. What's this down here? Oh yeah, skill points are attached to certain cars.
Here to unlock car masteries. Every car has its own set, offering unique perks and bonuses. But skill points can be spent on any car you own.
We'll just unlock one. Just for the hell of it, but yeah, every car has its own skill tree.
200 yards. Turn left.
What free property?
Great news! I've found a driver for our first showcase event. A rookie, no less. Unproven, but highly skilled. Huge potential. I think they're going to make this one to remember. So, you doing anything right now?
Yeah, I am. We'll do that in the next episode. What's on about free property? I've already got one. Do I have another? I don't know. I can't. Oh, that's a lot bigger than I thought it was. Although, is that the 4th Road Bridge? Yes, it is. Probably won't be able to go over it, though, unfortunately. Yeah, that's a bit bigger than I thought it was, but obviously it is technically the same size as Australia. No idea what it's open on about.
Ah, oh, no, here we go. You have a VIP pass, do you? Well, the house is yours. Right this way. Let me show you around.
In a bit. I want to show me everything in this game, I swear. There's something else here as well, yeah. Oh, four more wheel spins now. Alright, we'll do these again. A shirt, not bothered. A dance, not really bothered.
I expect to see those dance moves next time you're on the podium.
Another shirt. Come on, give me some money at least, or a car.
Or try new ones.
Yeah, we got a Cuda. Not something you'd see on the British roads, but you know what? That's something I talked about in
turn around when it is safe to do so.
My original criticism of the car pack,
the car list. It was a bonus board. Cuda's had their team hide them all over the place. That one was good for an influence boost.
Tractors don't go that fast.
In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right. You have arrived at your destination.
In into the next chapter.
Look who it is. Ready to get back into the real excitement? I'll bet you are. Right, we've closed some roads over the coast. You'll want to take your car there. Can't let you out the stunt vehicle yet. You'll understand when you see it.
Let me guess, it's some big off-road thing or a truck or something.
Off to meet the stunt unit on the South Moors. And don't make them wait too long, yeah? I don't like that.
Give me my classical music back. There you go. Six minutes to get there and we're already failing miserably. Come on, Alpha, you can do it, even if it is raining.
In 400 yards, turn right. Turn right.
Like I've seen a lot of cars with roof boxes on them. Typical British thing, that. You'll put it on your roof for a holiday and then you leave it on there for months on end without ever taking it off. Despite the fact that you'll be using up more fuel out of your car. Oh dear. Rain playing havoc then with the handling. That is not a wall I can go for. Come on, get up the hill. Oh, here we go, the Great British Roundabout.
At the roundabout, take the third exit.
Always give way to the right. And then you can plow up. Give way to the right, you cheeky bastards. There's always one on the roads that does that. Like I would give 6 minutes to do this, and even with me crashing into that bridge wall, I'm gonna do it in less than half that.
Here we are. I'll do the final briefing and then you're up.
This better be better than the last one. Oh,
no jets or
the Audi
this time.
The Auto Union.
High-speed drive
as
along
it called.
The coast road. Apparently it's all the same movie. I wouldn't know. I haven't read the script. You're driving this. What can I say? Sometimes there are perks in this job.
Very good car, this. Despite the way it looks.
Scene 29. Beauty Drive. Action!
Insanely quick for a car from 1939.
That's a 90-year-old racing car. It's gonna take some handling. Just don't hit anything, whatever you do.
Oopsie. Sorry. Could have picked a drier day to do this.
Coming up on the coast road now. Remember, we're going for elegant, smooth, fast. So put your foot down.
I am doing more than 140. crap caravan.
You in one piece?
A caravan had to kill me, didn't it?
Alright, it's time for another take.
Goddamn typical British caravans. Always getting in the way. Try again.
Here we go. Scene 29. Beauty Drive. Action!
I know. Let's go interior. Let's be proper classic. Oh dear. Immediately
nearly down. That's a 90-year-old racing car. It's going to take some handling. Just don't hit anything, whatever you do.
I already have. Oh, for God's sake.
Come back around and we'll try again.
Two minis I have to just hit. Two of the smaller cars on the road and I hit them.
Here we go. Scene 29. Beauty Drive.
Maybe outside is better.
Action!
Hopefully third time's a charm.
That's a 90-year-old racing car. It's going to take some handling. Just don't hit anything, whatever you do. Coming up on the coast road now. Remember, we're going for elegant, smooth, fast. So put your foot down.
I didn't get killed by a caravan this time.
All the way up to the lighthouse. Come on! Straight line speed! Here we go! That was beautiful. Yeah, the shot, I mean. Car and the setting and the whole effect. Your driving was half decent too.
Yeah, only took me 3 goes. I like how they've put the addition of headlights on this car because it doesn't have any on the Forza Motorsport 7. Obviously, with nighttime being something that you can't control, unlike on Forza Motorsport 7, they had to put them on. I wonder if that's how the car looked originally when it had headlights, if it ever did. Right. So yeah, I think that's going to be it for this episode. Bit of a long one, but well worth it. So yeah, we'll check out several things in the next episode, like the VIP house and other things. So yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.